Hi, dear doctor, friends, partners. This is Samar Das from The Ventilator Man. So today I'm going to show you the basic features of CardioLab C-Vent 1200T ventilator. So CardioLab is a company from Chandigarh and they are manufacturing these ventilators. I believe that Indian manufacturing ventilator are as good as any US or German ventilator, because whenever any US or German ventilator they are making any in their country, the country people are buying it very fast, and then they are able to sell it in all over world because they are selling too much quantity in his country first. So that enable them to produce more and more in a lower cost, or then they can sell it to all over the world. And I believe that the CardioLab C-Vent 1200T is as good as any US or German ventilator. It has all the modern features, whatever it's there in any US or German ventilator. So today I'm going to the basic features. So this is the back side of the machine. Here this is the O2 inlet and this is air inlet, so it can be connected to a compressed air line or can be mounted on the compressor. This is the compressor. I have not opened the compressor because it's too heavy. I'm just wanted to show you the basic features. So this is your power input. It is a normal Indian cable. This is on-off switch for this power input, and you can connect your display from here. This is HDMI connector, or you can connect any weak display. You can connect here with the VGA. USB port is there also, and this is your font, 12.1 inch touch display, and the display is tiltable, so you can tilt it side by side, or you can tilt it in up and down position. So as per your viewing need, you can tilt it. And this is your in-speed report. This is your nebulizer port. This is your expiratory port. To open the expiratory port, just you need to press this and it will come out. So this is your expiratory valve, and this is your flow sensor. The best part is the whole set is autoclavable, so there is no running cost, means there is no huge running cost, there is no replaceable flow sensor. It is autoclavable and very easy to take out, and you can do autoclave and then you can reset it. So to fix it back, it reset, just push it and it will get automatically locked. You will get a sound. So to start the ventilator, you have to press this button for few seconds. It is getting on. So this is your standby screen. So this ventilator can be configured as adult pediatric or neonatal pediatric or adult pediatric neonatal. So this machine is configured with adult pediatric and neonatal for three kind of patients. And if you have a patient, you have just detached from the ventilator and you want to continue with the last patient, so it will save the last patient data, and you can directly start the ventilation with the last patient data. Or if you want to start a new patient, you can select the new patient, you can select the patient type, you can select the lung type, normal, COPD or ARDS. Means if you select the lung type, it will automatically adjust the ventilator parameters as per the lung condition, because with the ARDS lung, it required very low ventilation, whereas with the COPD lung, it sometimes required higher volume. So this we will discuss on a later video. So you can select the lung condition, and also you can put the body weight. So according to the patient body weight, it will automatically take the ventilation parameters. And from this standby window, you can also do pre-test In pre-test, you can check all zero test, expiratory valve, expiratory flow test, air valve test, safety leak test, O2 sensor test, and we recommend that you should perform this test before putting to any patient, and this will ensure that the proper and accurate delivery of gases. So this will we will discuss later how to do this test. And to start ventilation, you just have to select your patient type, your lung condition, body weight, and then you can start directly, or if you wish to set some alarm parameters, alarm limits, you can do from here, or you can directly start the ventilation, or you can select the modes from here also, in with which mode you want to start the ventilation. Suppose you want to start with volume control, or you want to start with pressure control, or any other ventilator, you can start. So after confirming, it will allow you to adjust the parameters. See, suppose if you are like to start with VCV, we confirm, and it will allow you to start the parameters if you wish to change something, and then you can start ventilation directly. So before going to start the ventilator, I would like to show you the modes. So these machines have, as I said before, all the modern modes. So you can do VCV, SIMBVC, you can do the PCV, SIMBPC, APRB, Duo Vent, PRVC, SIMBPRVC, PSV, CPAP. Also, it has a smart vent. With the smart vent, there is the clinician interventions required is very less, because with smart vent, you can target any minute one ventilation, and according to the patient breath, according to the patient lung condition, it will adjust, it will try to reach to that minute ventilation. So this is smart vent. We will discuss smart vent on a later video. And also you can do BiPAP, BiPAP S, BiPAP ST, high flow. So this also we will discuss on later. And also if you select neonatal patient, then we will have the N BiPAP, NCPAP, which is called also bubble CPAP, and also the high flow. So with single machine, you can do the high flow, you can do the bubble CPAP, and as well as you can do the ventilation. So now I'm starting the ventilation. So in this window, you will find that there is pressure time curve, there is flow time curve, there is volume time curve, as well as there is PV loop, there is FV loop, there is PF loop. So three loops and three curves are on screen, and also the monitoring parameters are also in on screen. So this is the monitoring parameters. So it is very important to have a good monitoring display, because whenever you are giving ventilation, it is very important what is patient taking, what is patient effort. You can monitor all the things in one screen. This is very this will help clinician to understand the patient condition. And also if you want to go further monitoring, you can go to the monitoring section, and you can have a lots of parameters like compliance, static, dynamic compliance, resistance of inspiratory, RCXP, which is indicator of lung condition, RSBI, which is also indicator of weaning. We have work of breathing, and MBA spontaneous. This we will discuss in later videos, the uses of this, and how where it is very helpful, how we have to calculate all this. This we will discuss on another video. So in monitoring window, you have access to all the monitoring parameters to understand the patient condition, and what are the very modern parameters like RCXP, like work of breathing, like MBA spontaneous, frequency spontaneous, everything is there.
So nothing you have to buy separately, all are inbuilt. And from this window, you can also have the numeric trend. So the trend table is very attractive. A doctor can understand as per the time wise, what was the patient condition, how the patient condition is deteriorating or patient is getting good. Or there's the alarm info. You can get the all alarm information, whatever the alarm was there for which reason. You can get the all details from here, time to time. And also the graphical trend is there. You can find the graphical trend. You can go to the graphs and you can check the graphical trend from here. And then you can do the alarm settings also from here. If you wish to change any alarm at any point, you can change from here. This is your graph option. If you wish to, if you want that the all graphs and loops should not come to the display, you can switch it off on from here. Here is the access for you. And you can do the inspiratory hold, expiratory hold directly from here. Inspiratory hold and expiratory hold are very important because with inspiratory hold and expiratory hold, you can find the delta pressure, you can find the volume trapped, intrinsic PEEP. So these all we will discuss later, how to use inspiratory hold, expiratory hold and how it is very helpful. And then this is your system. So from here you can do the calibration, system info, setup, everything. This we will discuss on later. And these are the hotkeys. With these hotkeys you can this is the button for screen lock. You can do the screen lock for the safety purpose, and you can unlock it by pressing for few seconds. And then you have direct nebulizer button. If you press this, you will have a window to select the time and you can start the nebulizer directly from here. And then you are having O2. This means if you press this button, it will, the FiO2 will come to 100%. It is required for the auto suctioning procedure, and in some cases we will discuss on later also the suctioning parameters and suctioning process. And then you can do freeze. So if you can freeze your screen, and then you have a mute button. If you want to mute the alarm, you can mute from here. So alarm will get mute for 2 minutes. You can set the time also in the settings later. And then this is your power on off button. And there is and it is very user friendly machine. Why? Because all the setting parameters, whatever you want to change or set in any mode, so these are on screen and you just have to select, and then you can scroll it by this encoder, and by pressing this you can confirm it, or also you can confirm it from here by touch again. This is your rest settings. So the ventilator is very user friendly and very consist, because it is having all the modes, it is having all the maneuvers, whatever required. It is having all the monitor, because a ventilator should have good monitoring, should have maneuvers and modes. These must have a ventilator. So this ventilator is inbuilt with everything. So thank you friends, this all for today. If you have any further inquiry on this ventilator, you can contact us, you can call us on 7477763529, or you can log into our website, theventilatormanindia.com. Thank you.